Alright guys, it is my second vlog, and today I'm going to teach you how to crimp your hair, and how to do kind of like mini twists, but it'll just be like twists on this side, and then it'll be crimped all over. Alright, so first you're going to need your blow dryer, and you're going to blow dry your hair out. My hair is still wet from earlier today, I had to swim, so I'm just going to blow dry it out real quick. You hear music playing in the background, so it's not like so much dead noise in the back. If you have any questions about the songs I'm playing, feel free to hit me up. So here we go. Okay, so that was just to dry my hair a little bit more and make it more straighter. Or a little bit more straighter. Technically, before you do a heat protective style, you are not supposed to blow dry your hair. That is more heat damage on top of the heat damage you're already going to do. But my hair was wet, so I had to dry. Sue me. Okay. It's hot. Okay, so for this specific hairstyle, you are going to need some kind of heat protective oil. I am using Shea Butter Growth Miracle Back to Natural. It is an African Pride product and I love the smell, so I bought it. And I hope it makes my hair grow. Second thing you're gonna need is two forms of combs, preferably a loose one to comb through your crimped curls if you want. And the second one is two parts. You're gonna need a crimper. I just bought it. It's awesome. It's also water vapor, so I gotta fill it up. You're gonna need a few rubber bands. And then you're gonna need like some form of clips or a thing to hold down your your curls or whatever. Alright, so what you wanna need to do is go ahead and plug everything up. And turn it on. And I need to put some water in here. And hook everything up. Okay, so you're going to want to, whatever side you want to do your twist on is the side you want to part first. So I'm going to do my twist on this side. Kind of darkly in the middle when I part. And you decide how far back you want to go. Okay. Go ahead and put your other hair in a ponytail somewhat so it stays out of your way when you do your twist. Okay. So now you're going to part your twist. Oh, I'm going to need another clip. So now you're going to part your twists however you want them. however thick you want them or however thin. Mine's gonna be pretty thick, just so it don't take that long. And you're gonna use something to hold it down so it doesn't get in your way. Like that. Okay. Now you can put oil on it, or you can not put oil on it. I'm gonna put oil on my hair, just so it all has this clean shine effect. So I'm going to assume most of you know how to do two strand twist. But if not, I'm going to show you. Don't worry. I'm actually going to add a little bit more oil. Glistening. Now some people like to add gel to their twist or make it look wet. I don't like that feeling. So I'm not going to. But I'm not saying you don't have to either. All right. So you're going to take two parts, you're going to section your twist like really, really small, you're going to separate it into two parts, and you're going to twist and collect the hair. So like this, twist, collect the hair, twist, collect the hair, twist. It's kind of like braiding, but instead of three strands, you have two. And you're going to go ahead and do that for the whole section of your hair that you have chosen. And it's okay if you get other hair in it. I think the more kind of messy look you get, the more cooler it looks. You're going to go ahead and pin that down so it stays out of your way for your other strands. So go ahead and do that and enjoy the music. There's glitter in my hair. I forgot some hair. All right, I got about like four or three more. I'm gonna have a... There's some more even. I don't really care.
I have to make sure I still on Tyler.
No, I'm not on Tyler. Grab me random hair. That's fine. The only part I hate about getting down to my edges are the end. Make sure we're still on track. I can feel my thing.
Hot taste.
This is gonna be my last one. Go ahead and finish this up. That's my family coming home. And this is gonna be your last twist, or you know, however many you want. They don't have to be perfect. I'm gonna show you what mine look like. I don't really care if mine's perfect. So I've been doing twists ever since I started doing my hair on my own, since I was 12 years old. That's how long I've been doing my hair. So fairly young age. I got tired of my mom burying me with that. I'm so like, I think I'm gonna do my hair now. Alright, so this is what they look like. They're not, I mean, the best, but they get the job. Now, you're gonna take all your awesome clips that you have. 4 clips in a bobby. Wow. Okay. So, you can part this any way you want, or you don't have to part it at all. I know some girls who would actually leave like this, which is totally fine, totally cute, but my hair has to have some oomph to it. So, I am going to separate this right here. These are going to be like my bangs. I'm going to actually put these in a ponytail so they don't get in my way. Okay, so now I'm going to start from the bottom up. So my part isn't going to be perfect, but just a nice soft part all the way across. And then you're going to pin the rest up. Partly like not perfect, but it gets the job done. I have to show you this container. I bought at Family Dollar. It is awesome. Okay. You're gonna put your oil or your shea butter or whatever you use in your hair, you're gonna put that on now. You're gonna saturate your hair with it. You don't wanna over saturate. You just wanna make sure it's, you know, in your hair, guys. What I'm using is hair growth oil, but like I said, it's really a good heat protectant as well. Okay. So now, here's where you can see it. You're gonna part this in the middle, and you're gonna separate it. Pin it up. It's out the way. You're gonna take another little piece. If you want to put this, it's fine, but I'm very precise, and like my crimp's very, I don't know. It's just like I'm done well. And you're gonna pin half of that up. I hope you can see this. Like that. Okay? Okay. Now, You're going to take your crimper, you're going to take your curling iron, you can take your flat iron, and you're going to crimp, curl, or flatten. Some people leave it like this. Some people comb it out. I'm gonna leave it like that for now. And I'm gonna finish the back. So enjoy the music. And remember, you can do them as big or as small as you want. I'm gonna do mine not small, but neat. I am not a Taylor Swift fan, but I really like this song. And you hear me counting because the directions say leave it on for 10 seconds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 19. Now, if you have these problems like me where the roots aren't quite crimped, you can actually just stretch them out. You go ahead. Okay. I'm gonna show you the back. That's what it looks like. Please let me know if you cannot see this. Okay, and then you're just going to finish the rest of your head. Just like that. Now this works just as fine as taking it down, bringing it up in the night, and taking it down in the morning. But I want to be difficult. So. Plus I just bought this, so I want to use it. The bigger you do, the more wavier it'll be. I recommend using these. Not rubber bands, Not anything that will pull your hair out when you're doing your hair. Because those really break. I love them. If you guys know any good music to do your hair to, put it down in the description below. I listen to pretty much anything, so I do not discriminate. I have more playlists, but this is the one I chose this time. This song's kind of depressing. So. Might turn it. Got some hair. That's all right. All right, so I'm getting into my twist, right? Now you can crimp your twists however you want. You can crimp them down, you can crimp them back. I'm gonna crimp mine down because they just hang that way. They automatically hang that way. And I am not one to force my hair to do anything because it won't do it regardless. So whatever it wants to do, go for it, bro. All right. So as you go, I already put oil on the back of those, but as you go, just reinate some oil. Get that growth in there. That silky shine. I feel like if you put oil in it, it makes it more crisp, shinier. I don't know. It might last longer. I'm not doing this any kind of way. I'm just parting it however my hair falls. It's way more natural and it looks way more prettier. You want to just do it however your hair falls. Don't try to force it.
I'm not holding my own home.
this is a crimper by Infinity Pro. I buy all my heat products by them. Conair. This one uses heat and water. So it's not all heat damage, so to speak. And it looks much crisp and pretty with steam, I think. So I do recommend it. Shout out to Conair Infinity Pro. Right now I'm just crimping my individual twists. I feel like the longer you keep it on, like you hold it down, the harder the crunch. The lighter you keep it on, the softer the crunch. So the more natural it is. So this part's gonna get a little tricky. I'm gonna separate some hair and my twists. We're almost done. Whew, 30 minutes. I'm gonna separate these. I like this song. I'm gonna turn around so you can see what it looks like. When you see I'm not parting it in no particular way, I'm just parting it to get it done. But I am parting it smaller because I like mine more thinner. I don't know. Applying oil as I go. I need some more water. Okay, and finish this up, and then we're going to finish my twist, and then we're going to be done. This is Dance Apocalyptic by Janelle Monáe. She is a pretty awesome character. I think she's awesome. All right. Granddaddy. I bought my hair. Sorry. I'm gonna burn my scalp. That didn't work.
I like being independent, not so much of an investment. No one to tell me what to do. I like being by myself, nobody entertain anybody else. No one to answer to. But sometimes I just want somebody to hold.
Alright, so now I'm just crimping my twist and then we're gonna work out on our front.
I don't really like big crowds. I tend to shut people out. I like my space. Yeah. I love to have a song made. You gotta give it to me someday. And I know it'll be worth the wait.
Last twist. Alrighty. Now this is what they look like, and I'm gonna start on my front. This is what it looks like. Okay, now we're just gonna start on this little section and then we'll be done. And you're gonna oil this section. Just like you did the back. Make sure it's nice and oiled so you don't get any heat damage. Just a little bit more. My hair is a little thick, so make sure it works. Scrub, dub, dub. Okay. So this is kind of like the bang part because this part is twisted up. So instead of curling it back, you're going to curl it forward, if that makes sense. I'm going to show you. So it's going to be like that. Okay? So you're going to start actually... we start from the bottom up. So we're gonna cut this in half. Okay. Put this half in the section, or this half in the ponytail. And we're gonna crimp this kind of like this way down so much that we have the part, but enough so it looks like we have bangs. Okay. And you can easily just pin this back with your banana clip so it doesn't get in your way. Yeah, just call that a banana clip. Whatever. Make sure if you feel like you don't have enough oil, put some more on there.
Yeah. Okay. Something's in my eye.
Wow, something's in my eye. His hair. That was irritating. Okay, last little section. Okay, so you're just gonna finger a little bit, loosen it up, kind of let it hang. So this part, you're gonna bring down and forward, like that. But you're gonna start from the bottom and work your way up. So I'm gonna start under, and instead of doing a straight part across, I'm gonna do a diagonal part. Like that. Okay, so when I crimp it, it crimps diagonal. We're gonna finish that section up. So I gotta let some of the smoke out. Getting a little cloudy in here. And continue with the diagonal part. If you want the fall out. This is gonna be really pretty. It's like, oh my god! Yeah! It's like, oh my god! You did it! I don't have to put it in my last little part.
So this is what it looks like, and you're just going to spread it out just a little bit. All over, however you want it. So it's kind of puffy in the front one for me. Some people might not be okay. I'm okay with. If you're not okay with that, what you can do is take a section and crimp it together. That way it's all you're on the same beat. No, it's not as puffy. But I don't mind puffiness. So that's just something personal. So this is what it looks like. Front. Side. Back and then other side. Okay. All right, thanks guys, thanks for watching. I will be re-vlogging next Monday on, I don't remember, but I will post it in the link, post it in the post below. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, you can comment, please share, and repost. I'm just figuring it because I'm obsessed. How to tie this down? You can get a silk scarf and tie it all around. Some people will just clip it down in place all over, and so when they wake up, they just take the clips out and they kind of finger it and go. It's really just, you know, how you feel on doing your own hair or how you feel is comfortable wrapping it down. I do suggest you wrap it down, that way you absorb the crispness of it. What you can do is spray humidity spray on it if you are completely natural like me and your hair frizzes up on the sides like that. You can spray humidity spray and you can spray flat iron spray, but flat iron spray is, it freezes it in place. So I also have my looseness, but it freezes the texture, the curl, the wave. That's what it does. Okay? Bye.